Hey, it's Mike here, and today, high cholesterol and heart disease. It appears that most people today now believe that high cholesterol does not play a role in heart disease, that that's just old thinking. That's the old way. And it makes sense because a quick Google search will yield a ton of results reinforcing that belief. You have low carb doctors like Dr. Hyman telling you that the real concern isn't the amount of cholesterol you have, and low carb Chris Kresser telling you that, checkmark, diets high in saturated fat and cholesterol don't cause heart disease. Let's go to Burger King. Or you can stay and watch while we look at the science, look into our arteries at how heart disease starts and progresses. Then we will see if basing your dietary choices off the idea that high cholesterol just doesn't matter is a good idea or not. Low-carb educators present themselves as sort of renegades going against the authorities on the grounds that the authorities are wrong. With an authority like the National Institute of Health's Heart, Lung, and Blood Institute, who outright just says that high cholesterol causes heart disease by building up on the artery walls. So is the NIH and a variety of other health authorities with the same view around the world just out of touch? We will see. Now at this point, I could pin population studies observing that higher cholesterol is associated with higher heart disease against dairy industry and egg industry funded other observational studies saying the opposite, but people would probably just say correlation isn't causation, and then just outright deny everything I say. So instead, I want to look directly at the well-documented mechanisms in which high cholesterol causes and furthers the development of heart disease. We're going inside the artery. Ms. Frizzle, get your school bus. To start, let's familiarize ourselves with what cholesterol actually is. Cholesterol is essentially little packages of fat in protein, lipo or fat proteins, lipoproteins. These are waxy, gooey, sticky particles. Just using some logic, the more waxy, sticky gooiness you have, the harder it is for things to move. We know this from life. This is especially a problem in pipes like our arteries. Fats clog them. Looking at a more human scale example of this, all of the fat that we flush down the drain and poop out clogs our plumbing systems. Our actual sewers, from the San Francisco Chronicle, quote, "Just as cholesterol can slowly constrict human arteries, the fat buildups can go unnoticed until they constrict the sewer with catastrophic or at least disgusting consequences. These buildups are called Fatbergs, which are essentially the plaques of our sewer system's arteries." All right, back to the body. Let's look step by step at how heart disease and artery disease in general progresses, starting with step number one, an injury. It has to start with some damage to the lining of our arteries, and many things can cause this injury, just like how many things can injure your skin. A major one is reactive oxidative species or free radicals, particles that are unstable, they need another electron, and they might just pull that electron out of the lining of your artery and cause some damage. Oxidized LDL or bad cholesterol particles are one of these reactive particles that is well established as a cause from this horrible study that killed rabbits, quote, "Cholesterol oxidation products have been reported to cause acute vascular injury in vivo or live subjects." The higher your LDL, the more likely it is to oxidize and do damage. And other causes of artery wall injury include bacterial or viral infection, hypoxia, which is low oxygen, turbulent blood flow and shear stress, environmental irritants such as tobacco, and hyperlipidemia, which is high cholesterol and triglycerides. Next up, we have step two, a response to that injury. We have a buildup of white blood cells, which traps passing by cholesterol and essentially forms a zit. In particular, we get white blood cells known as macrophages, which are designed to engulf the threat and neutralize it, but instead they indiscriminately also engulf the cholesterol and create what is called a foam cell. From this study, when these macrophages eat that cholesterol, quote, "there is little negative feedback of uptake, and thus these cells become grossly engorged with lipids." They just don't know when to stop eating. No matter what here, having lower levels of cholesterol makes the situation better, and higher levels make it worse. With less cholesterol flying by, the injury has a better chance of just healing and not being a threat. It's simple logic, like having more cars drive over a pothole is gonna make it worse, or repeatedly hitting your scab on your knee is gonna prevent it from healing. The more fat you have going through your blood, the more fat there is to build up. We're talking about fatty streaks, not sugary streaks or salty streaks. Now to the final step, step number three, a rupture. This is the main cause of heart attack death. It's not slow buildup. It's that inflamed area rupturing and breaking off and blocking off your artery entirely in the form of a thrombosis. Back to this study, quote, dying macrophages, those immune cells, release their lipid contents and tissue factor, leading to the formation of prothrombotic necrotic core, a key component of unstable plaques that contributes to their rupture and the ensuing intravascular blood clot that underlies myocardial infarction and stroke. That's heart attack and stroke. But does cholesterol actually contribute to this rupture? Yes, in fact, it does. As liquid cholesterol becomes solid inside your artery wall, it can form cholesterol crystals. From this study, quote, the crystals appeared as needles, and from the journal Nature, quote, minimally modified LDL can lead to cholesterol crystallization. From this study, listen to this, quote, crystalline cholesterol is found as a hallmark of advanced atherosclerotic plaques. Look at these guys, they're brutal. You do not want these in your arteries. Yes, these cholesterol crystals are considered a major cause of rupture because they have a unique ability to pierce your artery wall. They literally pop off that fibrous cap on your artery wall lesions. They essentially pop that zit from the inside out, a bit like the movie Alien. Gross, I know. So the higher your LDL is, the more there is to modify into these little cholesterol death spikes. And looking to other causes of rupture, everything from stage one, that injury, should apply here because after all, it's still your artery wall. Now to one of the reasons I eat the diet that I eat. A whole food vegan diet intercepts every stage that we've talked about. Step one, the injury. It keeps a high antioxidant status, which buffers against those free radicals. And vegans on average have way lower LDL than meat eaters and vegetarians, so you have less oxidizable LDL. It also prevents that hypoxia or low blood oxygen, which can be caused by postprandial or after meal lipemia, which from this study can be induced by high animal fat consumption. Also, the high nitrate content of plant foods boosts the nitric oxide output of your artery walls. It releases gas, which essentially creates an anti-friction surface and prevents injury. Then to step two, that injury response. Vegans have lower levels of LDL, which means they have less for those macrophages to eat up, and they also have lower levels of hypertension or high blood pressure, about 50 to 75% on average, depending on the study. So that's less pressure, less friction to increase the inflammation there. Speaking of, this study put people on a vegan diet and their inflammation markers lowered by a third, and that certainly helps throughout this entire process. Then number three, again, less LDL means less cholesterol crystallization, less likely to pop that zit, and we just have lower blood pressure and less lipids flowing by, exerting pressure on and potentially rupturing that artery lesion. So it's no wonder that Dr. Esselstyn's whole food vegan trial on people with advanced cardiovascular disease showed rapid artery clearing and about 100 times lower incidence of heart attack and stroke in those that stuck on the diet compared to those that didn't over a 12-year period. But wait, in low-carb Dr. Hyman's article, he said, quote, 75% of people who have heart attacks have normal cholesterol. So that means no matter what your level is, cholesterol is going to do the damage anyway? Nope, we are just looking at a sick population where normal is actually high. A normal LDL or bad cholesterol is between 100 and 129, and a low level is just under 100. We are best off with the levels of newborn babies and primates, which is an LDL of about 50 to 70. This is how many studies are able to demonstrate that lower cholesterol does not lower heart disease because they're still going from high to high. There's still everything you need to create oxidation, artery wall damage, and cholesterol crystallization. In summary, high cholesterol causes heart disease. It's not the only cause, which is a fact that many people use to divert attention away from how dangerous cholesterol is in high amounts, but it is one powerful trigger and it certainly drives the progression of atherosclerosis and heart disease. It causes artery wall injury, it causes an artery wall injury response that is worse, and it pops that artery zit that eventually kills us. Finally, a whole food vegan diet combats all three of those stages through things like a higher level of antioxidants, a lower LDL, and lower inflammation, and more. So don't believe the hype. Diets high in cholesterol do cause heart disease, and we can reverse it, which is the awesome part. All right, that's it for today. A quick reminder, I do partake in another YouTube channel, which is Tiny It Yourself, a tiny house channel. It's all about doing things DIY. We have a bunch of cool videos coming up, like 3D printing for a tiny house and cool stuff like that. So go check it out and subscribe if you're interested. And also subscribe here if you haven't already. Hit that notification bell. Also, let me know down below if you still think that cholesterol has nothing to do with heart disease. And feel free to share this if somebody is trying to argue with you about it. All right, feel free to like the video, and I will see you next time. Thank you for watching.